And here we go. Hello there, thanks for joining me. I am AV Storyteller and this is my Let's Play Sid Meier's Pirates. Thanks for joining me. Right, you rejoin the dread pirate Roberts on the cusp of his revenge. We have found Montalban's hideout. We are just a short journey along the coast to Cutlass Shallows. We will then make land and travel inland to X marks the spot. Where are we on the world map? We are at Villa Hermosa. So, and it's a bit difficult to see because of all the writing along here. But we've got Nuva, that place there, which is just on the map. Just there. So without further ado, let's just quickly check the status, just remind everyone. Started in 1660, the Buccaneers Heroes are the English captain. I'm now 29 years old and in fair health. Being at sea for 24 months, I've got a massive crew of 372, which is content, which puts us in a excellent situation for this land battle, because this land battle is going to be absolutely devastating. It's a tough battle. I don't think they intend for you to actually win this battle, but fortunately, you don't actually have to. All you need to do when it comes to the battle for the Marquis Montalban, is to actually just get one group of soldiers to the main gates. You don't actually have to defeat every single crew. So there's Cutlass Shallows, which is there. So I thought if we just make land here, just to the left of it, and then cut along there, we should find it. And I can talk more about land battles as we do this. Yes, we will anchor here, mateys. So, and there's the arch rock that was on the map. So, using the compass down here, we want to be heading in roughly that direction, I'm thinking. Yeah, mostly with land battles, you have to defeat all the enemies, all the troops. But with this, you just need to get one of your group of troops to the main gates of the fortress in order to confront the Marquis Montalban for the final duel. And some epic music to see us off. Oh, and there it is. Superb. Oh. Walk right through the wall. That was easy. You have tracked the evil Marquis Montalban to his fortified hideout. An army of injured mercenaries block your path. Super. Right, this is the first time we've done the land battle, so instead of actually just beelining a troop to the fortress, what I think I was going to do actually is use this opportunity to talk about tips and strategies about land battles, because we haven't had one yet in this Let's Play. Please excuse me, it's absolutely boiling here at the moment. It feels like I'm in the Caribbean and I'm in Scotland. It's so hot. Right. Now, forget the old adage of the best defense is the offense. They've never played Sid Meier's Pirate Land Battles. The best defense is an excellent defense. And it's all about hiding in the woods and letting them come to you instead of you charging out on across the plains to them. So let's see what locations we can pick from. None are great, to be perfectly honest. I kind of like this one because my flank is protected by this rock, which is impenetrable. You can't move troops across that, which means, and I've got this forested area here which I could keep my buccaneers. I've got three buccaneer units and one officer unit and two pirate units. Buccaneers have rifles, but the pirates and the officers are good and excellent close range combatants. So I'm thinking this actually, let's quickly check the other locations again. That had the advantage of high ground. That's much of a muchness. I'm liking this because then I can focus on putting my buccaneers at the front here and protecting them with the pirates. Although we are in a bit of a dip and height does play a part. You get height bonuses and flanking bonuses and morale bonuses as well. That's where you've defeated one of their groups and your troops are feeling bolstered by it. And likewise, you can rout an enemy group. Basically make them retreat before you wipe them out completely by just picking on them and just attacking them by multiple units. That had the advantage of height, but only there's no place to retreat to. Again, that's in a dip as well. Yeah, gonna go with this one. Now there's gonna be something like 200 or 300 enemy troops. It's a tough battle. I don't think they expect you to actually try to defeat them, but basically make a beeline and get one group to there. But for this occasion, I'm going to see if we can actually defeat all their land troops. And because I'm only doing this for experimentation, just basically show you the land battle. If that fails, I actually might just reload, because it will be quite difficult actually gaining that number of troops again. It might slow down the let's play considerably. So maybe just in this one occasion, we may need to reload, but we'll see how we get on. So we have the normal movement. If you hold down the shift button, you get the option of moving between your other units. Then you can tell it to skip a turn and toggle the grid. I always keep the grid on. It helps me greatly just to keep the angles all correct and make sure exactly where the actual border finishes. Retreat. Never hit retreat. And then you got the holding down control. You've got the ability just to turn your units rather than moving them in a particular location. Oh dear, that was a mistake. Yeah, that's a great start. Okay, but is this how it's going to be? Let's have a quick check. Just center the map. I'm going to need a pirate unit to protect our flanks here. So where would we better put the buccaneers? I'm thinking there and there actually. But I can't put them there because I need my troops there. So I'm thinking there and there. So pirates, you can move there. And you want them in the forest because that gives them protection against enemy fire. I correct my early mistake. To bring these over, I'm thinking. Yeah, you get one movement through a forest and two across land. Might not be a bad idea just to put them there. Try and get some early shots off. They're not. Ooh, I could put them there actually. That might be even better. They've got the protection of the forest and they're close, but they can't be attacked. Someone might actually run them around there. I'll have to keep my eyes on that. We'll soon find out if any enemy troops are coming in that direction. That would be a good way to sneak out, actually. Let's move them there. Do I have any more troops with any more movements? No, it's just you. Okay, let's see what they do. These axe units of the Indian mercenaries are very, very good at close combat. Right, okay. They're in range. So let's open fire on these. One, two. They could be coming around there to attack, so it may actually be possible to get through that gap there. That being the case, I should move some pirates up there to protect them. And if I put my buccaneer units there, let's try moving the pirates down there. think that's all I can do at the moment. I think I'm gonna hold you there. Let's move you out here. Yeah, see if we can get some fire in action. So we can switch target by holding down shift and pressing the number 6 or clicking on it. So because we've already attacked them once, let's attack them again, trying to destroy them completely. Right, they are definitely been suggesting that they can come through there, so I'm going to have to move my troops back, and I just realised I've boxed them in. So what I would have to do is, let's move you there. Can I switch target to them? Hit that same group again. That surely should be every other. Yep, they're routed. Excellent. What I'll do, I'll move you back one. Hopefully you can still fire, which you can. That is excellent. Superb. And then I'll move my pirates up here to the high ground. And we'll get them. Oh, I wanted to turn first the enemy. Forgot, run out of movements there. Right, okay, Buccaneers. Let's put the officers in that angle there, because that's obviously can be attacked through as well then. They're just out of range, but I like where you are. So we'll skip you. There's going to be a lot more troops than what these are. So I'm happy with my position. So they can go 1, 2. Right, so I'll skip that. So I've got a defense of 4, a morale of 1, and a height advantage of 2. See how they can all quickly stack up. Right. First of all, Buccaneers. You don't seem to be able to fire on them. What I might do is move them out and then attack of 4, height advantage of 2 to their 3, so I've got 5. That's superb. Let's center the view and fire! Try and soften these up. And you can do the same. This is a great position. I'm not going to leave that position of height. So, because if I go there and up there, I'll be giving them the height advantage. So I'll let them come to me. Right, officers, you can stay there. Buccaneers, let's move you up here. So I've got 8 to their 3. Wow. Awesome. I actually expected there to be a lot more of them. So now that was brilliant. That was excellent. Now we get the duel with the Marquis himself. Maximum effort. Remember me? I'm one to the feet. Get in there. Nice. on your knees, sir. You are a master tactician, sir. Truly, I have done your family a terrible injustice. I give you 100,000 gold doubloons, which are rightfully yours. Among my crew are 8 specialists of extraordinary skill. Henceforth, they will serve you. I myself will serve you as your cabin steward, because we don't kill people in Sid Meier's Pirates. But that's excellent. If you didn't have all the specialists, you now get them for defeating the Count, the Marquis Montalban. Huge amount of gold, and you get him to be your cabin steward. Make me some tea. And get me some rum. Phenomenal. Let's return to the ship. No, sail away. Sweet. Let's just have a look at the map and the mission on that one. That was awesome. So, very happy. Unsurprisingly, 186,646 golden doubloons. Let's fleet status. That's an yes. Specialist. So, that's all the specialists. Personal status. Villains avenged. 10 out of 10. You can pull them on the board. So, that's a huge bonus to your... to your end of game score. So let's have a quick recap, actually, of the illustrious Captain Roberts' wealth points. 13 out of 24. So 5,152 gold banked. Lots of land. So now what we have to focus on is improving our rank with all the nationalities, defeating the rest of the pirates, which are Jack Rackham, Bart Roberts, and Captain Kidd. We're number one. We haven't ransacked a town yet. We have to do that. Apparently, that's all the rage. And we need to find our other 3 lost relatives. And of course, there's buried treasure. And not forgetting romancing the beautiful governor's daughter. But the big money comes from the lost cities. And there's 4 lost cities to find, 4 pieces of the map per lost city. And our treasure map says that the lost city of the Incas was also in the vicinity of Villa Hermosa. But we have no coastline yet to really narrow this down. We could be searching for quite some time to find that. This would be an ideal opportunity to save your game, go hunting around the map for a few months until you find it, then reload your save game, and then just make a beeline for that point, because it will be there. I'm actually just going to put in a quick save there. So, the next course of action. Right, how do we get more information about lost cities? A great way of getting more information from lost cities is now by romancing the governor's daughter. So if you do a perfect dance with the governor's daughter, because they can't tell you anything more about the Marquis because you've defeated him, they would instead give you a piece of information of a lost city of the Incas. So she's in Cumané. Where was Kumani again? Of course, it could be any beautiful daughter that you do. But obviously, you want to complete the romance as well and get your pirate happily married as well. That's way over there. I still have my heart set on a Spanish governor's daughter. So, let's have a quick pop into the pirate's haven, actually, I'm thinking. And then we can go about our business of tracking down Baron Raimondo and rescuing the rest of our family while collecting all these map pieces and romancing the ball gown off a beautiful governor's daughter. Talk to the captain. Golden doubloon. Well, yep, just go there. We'll try and catch you very quickly on the outside. Visit the tavern. Yes, we deserve a drink, lad. Welcome aboard, mateys. A mysterious traveller offers to sell you a Spanish rotter. This is a nice to have. It basically displays all the little mini towns along the map that you haven't discovered yet. And seeing as I'm rolling in the gold doubloons, I'm going to treat myself to a little Spanish rutter. Reninta. Cataluna. Vera Crookstotters, they say she's a real beauty. He read my mind. Where is Vera Crooks? Do, 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 do. Ah, right there. I say we pop along there and have a quick word. Buy a bit more food for my vast crew. Let's stick that on there. Sydney Town. Oh, I forgot me pirate. He went shooting off that way. Oh dear. Right, not forget it this time. Not forget it this time. Tavern. More men. I don't need it anymore.
Peter room.
Yep, okay, if we come across her. It's on my other ship. And sail away. Right. Where's this pirate? Got it. Do 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 do. Let's soften his trip a bit. And I think one more. Down you go, sir. And go for the legs again. And he's down. I just need to turn the volume down. That's actually just a bit loud for me. Sorry for that. And let's cheekily sell it back to the pirate. Fell.
A neat set of stars.
Do do do. Right, where is Baron Raimondo? Yeah, he was there like 9 months ago. And we've got a Mr. X Shawshanks, 10 months ago. Yeah, all this information is very dated. La Habana, 2 months ago. That may be the place we go to next. Captain Kidd, in that direction. So maybe we should be sweeping around there on our return trip. Lost City. Treasure ship. Treasure ship. Come to the Dread Pirate Roberts. Oh, I'm going really slow. Come on. Come on. Get in there. Just trying to get a better angle of attack before we start. Indian raid on the city of Vera Crux, defeated by the militia. Let's cut across the north. Fire! Boom! Oh, she's struggling against the wind, Captain! ...136 crew. She's not going down without a fight. The ship is getting blown backwards by the wind here. Oh dear. Oh dear. And that's why you get buried treasure found at the bottom of the ocean. Oh, happens to the best of us. Unbelievable. I got cannon happy there. Cannon happy. Let's go and console myself in the arms of a beautiful governor's daughter. Yeah, about that treasure ship. King will be pleased. Thank a Spanish treasure ship. It had nothing on it. Yeah, he didn't buy it. Damn it. I'm going to have to make nicey-nicey. Welcome aboard, mateys. Tell me more. Thank you very much. You are now the first most notorious pirate on the entire Spanish main. Fear not, madam, you reply graciously. I've been trying to. Stop rubbing it in. Which reminds me. So, we've made Duke with the English, so it might now be a good time to switch allegiances and maybe focus on attacking the English rather than Spanish. And the Spanish are at war with everyone, which is great. Do. What else is around here, mappy wise? I'm at the very edge. Can't see anything. It seems a bit desolate. So, I think maybe we should pop out to La Habana. I'd rather not remind the beautiful governor's daughter at the far, like, western side of the Spanish main. It makes it very difficult to get back there. So, here goes the slog. All the way back. Let's change view. Yep, we are in the middle of nowhere. But we have a favourable wind, which is nice. And that's a maximum zoom out. Try and catch all these white clouds. This will certainly make the journey go a lot quicker. As we slowly tack back. So, actually, this might be a good time to actually make a cut here, so you don't have to watch this slow journey to the east. So, because I'm basically going to head over here. I'm probably not going to meet any ships along the way. That was the game's cue to just send in 5 ships at that point, but no, it didn't fall for it. So, I think that's what I'm going to do, actually. I'll do this slow, painful tacking against the wind to get us back to La Habana. And I hope to see you in the next episode, where we hunt down the evil Baron Raimondo, rescue the rest of our family members, and woo Governor's daughter. So, I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, please leave me a comment, like, subscribe, and I will see you for the next adventure. So, until then, take care of yourself, and goodbye for now. Goodbye.